championship rosters. Representing the iconic Big Bad Bruins and the 1970 and 72 Stanley Cup champions.
They're still not that bad.
Number one, Eddie Johnston.
Seven, and almost 7 decades later, he remains a devoted
captain, he led the Black Bulls to 2 Stanley Cups in 1970 and 72, and still remains the franchise's all-time leading goal scorer. Known within these walls as the Chief, please welcome number 9, Johnny Bucyk.
Set it up. One more.
Set up again.
No.
You should have had that.
Plays over now. That's a great power play. Go, Coyle, go.
What is that, dude?
That's our first line center, too, this year. Up here. That was the easiest first career goal I've ever seen.
Yeah. Come on, Dad. There, calm down.
Everybody's spamming your phone, aren't they?
Yeah, they're calling me a bandwagoner.
I've been with this team since 2009. Suck my dick. Yeah. Right there! Are you kidding me? Take your time and gather. No.
Chicago goals scored by number 98, Connor Bedard.
Assisted by Taylor Hall, of course. Video tribute for Taylor Hall and Nick Foligno. Why did we trade him away?
Not a player to try and come back and give back any little bit of joy that we
First goal of the season for the Bruins' Frederick from Marlo at Montra at 11:22.
Damn.
Why?
That's very true too. You should have gave that to Luce. Oh my. Nice. How was that not a trip? How was that not a trip?
We won 6-5.
No way. Oh, if he scored twice in a game.
Some of the veterans that helped you out. Bruins stay on side. Postanov scores!
Yeah. Like, I will do aggressive moves and do not stop.
Oh! Too close to me. That was too close to me. Oh! No. Final two.
2 minutes left. 2 minutes left.
That's not full of four. Good pass! Good luck. Take that off. Goalie's gonna be going soon. There he goes. There he goes. There he goes. No ice. No ice. Don't you dare choke this game away. Ah, damn it. Get it out. Nice. Nice. Go. Goal. David Plastica. And good night. That's going to do it for this video here. Leave a thumbs up if you guys enjoy. Subscribe now if you guys are new. You know what to do. Go check out our website. The link's in the description down below if you're watching this on YouTube. Good game from the Bruins. 3-1 victory over the Chicago Blackhawks. One thing that I noticed from the Boston Bruins is that they play a lot more physical than they have in the last couple of years. The puck movement needs to be cleaned up a little bit better. There were times where Bruins had an opportunity to shoot the puck and they decided to pass it. And then there were times where the Bruins had a chance to pass the puck off to get a goal, but then they shoot it. Just clear up a little bit of those mistakes there. They might be a little bit decent. I think I actually agree with the GM of the Boston Bruins when he says they think that they at least have a playoff team. I think they do. I think they're just going to be in the middle of the pack for the Eastern Conference. I don't think they're going to be a top seed team like they were last year, unfortunately. But when you get in the playoffs, I guess anything can happen. I would hope to see them maybe win a round, maybe two. I don't know if they're going to be a Stanley Cup contender this year. But I kind of liked what I saw in the first day. Lucic brought a physical presence to that team. You can see that they're a lot more physical than they were last year. There was no intro to this video, as you guys can tell, because we were just getting there at the beginning of the ceremony, and I kind of just have to start recording. And I got a legit question for you guys. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you guys like the center ice balcony better? Or do you guys like the original seats that I sit in, Loge Box behind the net? It's a legit question because I actually loved the seats that we sat in last night. I would have probably sat a little bit lower in the balcony than we were at, but I'm not gonna lie, the center ice balcony, I was able to catch a lot of decent footage of game over there. Sometimes it's a little bit weird when I'm behind the net because I don't see where the puck is going behind the net or whatever. So legit question, let me know in the comments down below. You guys like those seats last night better? Or you guys like the original seats that I sit in better? Because I might go to games for the Bruins, right? And try to sit center ice in the balcony a little bit more. I'm not going to lie. But I would have to be like the first five rows though, to be honest with you. Because I feel like I could get some very good footage in the first five rows of the balcony. Those seats were phenomenal. I would definitely sit up there again in that section, especially where I had an aisle seat too. That was definitely a plus also. Shout out to my friend who let me tag along. That's the only reason why I sat up there, because I was asked to go to that game from a friend. So that's why I sat up there. And I'm not gonna lie, it was a learning experience for me too, because those seats were pretty decent. I would have sat a little bit lower, like I said, but those seats were pretty decent. I'm not gonna lie. Now, the ceremony. I'm glad I got to see Bergeron back. It was great to see him return to on the ice again. It was great to see Krejci, even Tim Thomas too, and Zdeno Chara. There was also Cam Neely in the house, and then Bobby Orr. We've seen Bobby Orr on this channel many times before, so it was just a reunion of the retired players hanging up in the rafters, and then there was also Bruins greats that were on the ice as well. Few of them that will get their number retired someday, and I guarantee it. Thank you guys for watching this video. It's been your boy Jesse, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Later, guys.